The Dark Bible. God, Satan, Jesus, Heaven. The back parts of God. And the Lord spake unto Moses face to face, as a man speaketh unto his friend, Exodus 33:11. And he said, Thou canst not see my face, for there shall no man see me, and live. And the Lord said, Behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock, and it shall come to pass, while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cleft of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand, while I pass by, and I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen. Exodus 33:20-23. Comment. In verse 11 we read that God spoke to Moses, face to face. Yet in seeming contradiction, we have later God telling Moses that he cannot see his face. Instead, God decides to show Moses his back parts. Back parts of course serves as a euphemism for ass. In other words, God here says to Moses, Thou shalt see my ass. I'll leave it to the readers to ponder the possible sexual orientation of God as he shows Moses his bare bottom. Beasts in heaven. And before the throne there was a sea of glass like unto crystal, and in the midst of the throne, and round about the throne, were four beasts full of eyes before and behind. And the first beast was like a lion, and the second beast like a calf, and the third beast had a face as a man, and the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. And the four beasts had each of them six wings about him, and they were full of eyes within, and they rest not day and night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was, and is to come. Revelation 4:6-8. Comment. Here we have a rare description of heaven, where it appears frightening with strange beasts. One cannot help to think that it seems more a description of hell than a heaven. See also Reverend 5. The Brethren of Jesus. After this he went down to Capernaum, he, and his mother, and his brethren, and his disciples, and they continued there not many days. John 2:12. Comment. This verse describes Jesus and his brethren. Jesus Christ's blood-related siblings directly contradicts the Catholic concept of the lifelong virginity of the Mother Mary. Some Christians have attempted to defend this contradiction by pointing out that brethren has two meanings. It could mean brothers, from the same parents, or it could mean colleagues or friends. Note, however, that the use of the word disciples suggests that brothers and disciples constitute two separate groups. Therefore, brethren must mean brothers in this context. Note also that Mark 6:3 mentions brothers and sisters that can only mean blood siblings. Also, nowhere in the Gospel of John or Mark does it mention Jesus' birth or Mary as a virgin. Considering that a virgin birth of the Son of God would seem of utmost importance, it appears rather odd that these Gospels do not mention it. Christ with horns. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. Revelation 5:6. Comment. Biblical scholars agree that a lamb refers to the crucified Christ. Strangely, Jesus here appears to look devilish with horns and multiple eyes. How can this description of heaven inspire an image of a peaceful afterlife with all these ghastly beasts and spirits about? See also Reverend 4. It should come to no surprise where some early Gnostic cults got the idea that not only the church, but Jesus represented Satan and the embodiment of evil. And who do the literalists claim as the seven spirits of God? Christ's temper. And found in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and doves, and the changers of money sitting, and when he had made a scourge of small cords, he drove them all out of the temple, and the sheep, and the oxen, and poured out the changers' money, and overthrew the tables, and said unto them that sold doves, Take these things hence, make not my Father's house a house of merchandise. John 2:14-16. Comment. Here we have Jesus' temper and violence showing. It must have taken considerable fortitude to drive all the money changers out and then have the nerve to pour their money out and turn over their tables. Consider what would happen today if a man entered a church bake sale and threw everyone out and violently turned over the tables. No doubt the police would come and throw him in the slammer. Jesus served as Hitler's role model. Here Hitler referred to the verse in one of his speeches. My feelings, as a Christian, points me to my Lord and Savior as a fighter. It points me to the man who once in loneliness, surrounded only by few followers, recognized these Jews for what they were and summoned men to fight against them and who, God's truth, was greatest not as a sufferer but as a fighter. In boundless love, as a Christian, and as a man I read through the passage which tells us how the Lord at last rose in his might and seized the scourge to drive out of the temple the brood of vipers and adders. How terrific was his fight for the world against the Jewish poison. Today, after 2,000 years, with deepest emotion I recognize more profoundly than ever before in the fact that it was for this that he had to shed his blood upon the cross. As a Christian I have no duty to allow myself to be cheated, but I have the duty to be a fighter for truth and justice. And if there is anything which could demonstrate that we are acting rightly, it is the distress that daily grows. For, as a Christian I have also a duty to my own people. When I go out in the morning and see these men standing in their queues and look into their pinched faces, then I believe I would be no Christian, but a very devil, if I felt no pity for them, if I did not, as did our Lord 2,000 years ago, turn against those by whom today this poor people is plundered and exploited. Adolf Hitler, in his speech on 12 April 1922. I almost shudder at the thought of alluding to the most fatal example of the abuses of grief which the history of humankind has preserved, the cross. Consider what calamities that engine of grief has produced. John Adams. Curse the earth. For, behold, the day cometh, that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble, and the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. Malachi 4:1. And ye shall tread down the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet in the day that I shall do this, saith the Lord of hosts. Malachi 4:3. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord, and he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse. Malachi 4:5-6. Comment. This last chapter of Malachi ends the book of the Old Testament. One would think it might end with a flourish of enlightenment. Instead we get fear of burning to death and can only look forward to the dreadful day of the Lord. With all the horrors recorded in the Bible, perhaps it should not surprise anyone to see the Old Testament end with the word curse. Evil from God. Out of the mouth of the Most High proceedeth not evil and good. Wherefore doth a living man complain, a man for the punishment of his sins? Lamentations 3:38-39. Comment. Here we have the little known verse that plainly asserts that evil as well as good comes from the mouth of God. At the same time, men who possess God-given evil must endure punishment for God's cruel gift. See also 2 Samuel 12:11 and I Kings 14:10. I will bring evil upon the evil spirit of the Lord. 1. And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took an harp, and played with his hand, so Saul was refreshed, and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. I Samuel 16:23. Comment. Here it specifically describes an evil spirit from God. What religious killer could not also view this passage as justification for his evil nature? Note that many murderers and serial killers have attributed the biblical God to the reason for their slaughters. If the religious right feels so adamant about eliminating violence and pornography from secular literature, then why have they not seen that the Bible has influenced more deaths and atrocities than any other literature in the history of mankind? See also I Samuel 19:9. The evil spirit of the Lord, 2. And the evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul, as he sat in his house with his javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand. I Samuel 19:9. Comment. Consider that many modern Judeo-Christians consider God the opposite of evil, yet here we have, again, the clear biblical wording of evil coming from the Lord. In early Christian history, several Gnostic cults believed that the Orthodox Church as well as the Old Testament came from Satan. The church, of course, labeled these Gnostics as heretics and burned their books as well as the heretics themselves. Reading the Old Testament appears to affirm the observation that God and Satan, if not one in the same,